Hello everyone, welcome to part 2 of my Byzantine Civilization 5 game. The last time I played through the first 153 turns, turned out I didn't get the best starting location possible, but I decided I was going to play it through anyway, just to see what happens. So sometimes that initial starting location, which looks bad, turns out not to have been that big of a handicap. In fact, with marathon games, losing a little bit of time early in the game usually doesn't handicap you so much in the late game. Okay, so that's... where's the horses? Oh, well, that's actually good. Right, I'll clobber that guy. What to do here? Optics gives me embarkation. Writing gets me the great library. I'm going to go for writing. Now, here, I just can't take the risk on that anymore. That archer down there should move on to the farm and pillage it. Right. So I'll let that warrior heal. I'll attack that guy. And do nothing with the worker. He's probably going to move over to the quarry here and pillage that now. Or maybe not. Why didn't he pillage it? I need another warrior is what I need. Should pillage it this time. Right. He'll come over here and pillage this one now. Yep. Anyway, I really should send this warrior back home. Okay, there's nothing else to pillage there, so... Oh, that's good. It's working the horses there, so I really do need to get the pasture up on there, but I need to fix these first. Oh, we got a great prophet. We're going to get first religion. That's nice. Usually you don't get the great prophet that early after 600. Worker... Great prophet. We'll found our religion. Okay, so. That's happiness, gold for each city. Following the religion. Tithe, gold for each 4 followers. I'm going to go with tithe there. And we have pagodas. I'm going to go with them. And our bonus belief. Whoa. That's absolutely everything. That includes pantheons. Well, let's look at this carefully. I've never played Byzantium before, actually, so I've never actually seen this option here. Cathedrals, one faith, one culture, one happiness, great work of art slot. Ceremonial burial, one happiness for every two cities. Church property, two gold for every city. Faith from Tundra. Desert folklore. Divine inspiration. World wonder provides two faith. Faith from copper, iron, salt. Feed the... Okay. God of craftsmen, open sky. This God of Craftsmen might be good, but fishing boats plus one production. Goddess of festivals, that's wine and incense. Food from camps. Plus two production if there's a specialist in the city. Missionaries. Okay, faith to, well, this one isn't really worth much. 100 gold each time a city converts. Itinerant preachers. Religion spreads further away. Messenger of the God. Missionary. Monasteries. Two faith, two culture. Mosques. Three faith, two culture, one happiness. Mosques would be good. That's the one I would normally go with for the second follower belief. Plus four faith, natural wonders. Gardens provide happiness. Hermitage gives culture and tourism. Religious center. Faster border growth. Religious texts. Religion spreads faster. Unity. Culture from jungle tiles. Happiness from cities on rivers. Sun god would be fun. Swords into plowshares. No. Okay. I'm going to go with mosques. And we'll found the religion. Right. Okay, so get rid of that bugger. Get out here and repair my quarries. That's what I need to do. Oh, we built a shrine over here. This is good. Now for a monument. Okay, so I suspect I'm not going to get Stonehenge, but it's hard to say. Right. Okay, as I recall, there was some barbarian knocking around up here. So I'll check that out. Meanwhile, I'll take out this guy over here. Yeah, take out that archer up there. And take out... Oh, come on. Take out that guy. Okay, that's better. Need to repair that quarry. Need to get up there and kill that bloody archer. Oh, well, that's inconvenient. Kill the archer, though, because the ranged attacks are annoying. And now we're on a hill, so defense will be better if this guy attacks, which he probably will. Yeah, he did. Now, what have I got here? Amphibious, cover, insta-heal. I'll go with shock 3 and fortify. See if I get lucky. Ah, good. I did get lucky on the defense there. Definitely need to let that warrior heal before I attack, because I can't see what's behind that brute here. Oh, and the bugger attacked and died. That was hilarious, actually. There's a hand axe. There's got to be an encampment somewhere. Oh, yeah, there is. There's one right there, so... I'll definitely have to go after that. But I need to make sure there isn't one sitting where I can't see it up here. Okay, that's writing. That's the quarry repaired. I really need a pasture on there, though. Okay, now... Optics. I'm going to go for that for the embarkation, because depending on the shape of the continent, embarkation will be handy. Well, this will tell me where Attila's capital is. Oh, he's way over there. Okay. Pasture is plus one production. So with the horses there, it actually gets us to a decent level of production for Constantinople. I'm still going to probably want to build a lumber mill or two, probably up on the tundra forests there. And again, there are hills there. Yeah, the production won't be too bad once the borders expand. Okay, Temple of Artemis. I wasn't even going to go for that one, so that's not a big deal. Four turns for Stonehenge. So if somebody snipes it now, it'd be really, really annoying. Eastern Orthodoxy. Who founded the religion? I'm thinking it... let's find out. Religion overview. World religions. Okay, the Celts have Catholicism. And somebody we haven't met is Eastern Orthodoxy. I must have missed a religion when it was founded somewhere along the way. I thought that was only the second one. Oh well. I got the religious beliefs I wanted anyway, so... right. Okay, good. This warrior's healed. Now I'll take out this bastard here. There's got to be a camp over here somewhere. Right. Wow, these are really nasty, raging, marauding barbarians. I need to actually do something about them. We got Stonehenge. Cool. Okay. Attack that guy. Got Stonehenge. That's nice. Stoneworks would be good to have. But... Okay, this is a toss-up. Pyramids means the workers work faster. And that's nice. And it's great engineer points. The Great Library is great scientist points. And additional science and a free tech. So it's a toss-up which way I want to go. Pyramids, I think. I think I have a better chance of getting pyramids because the other civilizations have had writing a lot longer than I have. So odds are they have a really good start on the Great Library. So I definitely want to... I definitely want to go for one that I'm more likely to actually get. So if the Great Library pops up over here in the next 50 turns or so, then we know for sure that that I made the right call. Oh, there's two archers there. I need that warrior to heal up before I go after them. Oh, maybe they're coming from this encampment here. On the upside, whacking all these barbarians is good for culture generation since I picked off the honor opener. Now, a brute's come along here. There we go. My warrior is healed. Now I'll go after the brute. Oh, brute attacked. Wow. Yeah, okay. That seems like a good idea. I doubt my location is a mystery to Poland for all that much. See if the barbarian's dumb enough to attack again without me having to do it. Nope. But that does for the barbarian. And I think I'm going to have to take that stupid archer. Oh, we got a promotion. What options? Heal every turn. That's March. That's the one I really want here. So I'll take that. And I'll clobber the archer there. And I'll clobber that archer. What a lot of archers. And I'll clobber that archer. What a lot of archers there. Okay, we're gonna have to whack that guy. Okay, so that's good. Okay. So we're up to 10 production. That's pretty decent there. Now I'll actually repair the farm. So unlike my previous playthrough, you can see that I didn't end up with a nice isolated peninsula thing attached by a narrow land bridge. Which certainly made the previous game a lot easier, as I really didn't have to contend with anybody. I'm not going to get into somebody else's wars at this point in the game, especially since my army consists of one scout and one warrior. Okay, so I'm going to work my way down this way to this encampment, which I need to get rid of. I think I'm going to have to build my third city somewhere over here, and maybe hope I get Petra, which I probably won't. Right. I am going to take that out. I got a bloody hand axe here. So far, so good there. Okay. Oh, there's another Pantheon is out. Okay, I'm going to have that next turn. Okay, that's repaired. So I'll go over there. Okay, so clear the encampment. Now we got this bloody hand axe here. Those things are annoying to kill. And they're a ranged unit, so optics. There's optics. That hasn't shown that it's repaired yet. Okay, I'm going to chop that forest. Okay. So I could go with drills, blitz, so I get a double attack. Or I could go with covered defense against range attacks. I'm going to go with that. Because this guy is ranged attacks. I'm going to actually heal a bit. Now, Bronze working seems like a good idea. That's going to lead me down to warriors. So, or swordsmen rather. So that's what the warriors upgrade to. So, okay, I'm going to have to attack this guy. And I'm going to have to get out of his range so I can heal a bit. Okay, that's a monument there. What to build? You know what? This city isn't doing great for anything else. I'm going to build a settler there. And just take the slow road after this guy. Find out where Sweden is. Okay. Okay, that's where the Celts are. Nice. Actually, I said earlier that my army consisted of a worker and a scout. I think when my scout wandered into those archers or whatever, yeah, over here, it didn't actually survive. And that's what I was saying, why the crazy promotion possibilities isn't a huge unbalancer in the game, because your units are still only so strong, so it doesn't make that big of a difference. Where the blazes did that hand axe go? There it is. Okay, so that's just about got it dealt with now. Good. Hand axe is done. That will certainly be beneficial. Okay, there's a statue of Zeus. I don't generally go for that one either. Usually because it's fairly heavily contested, so it's not worth the attempt to do that. Okay, so I can purchase stuff with faith, but I want to get up to 900 faith for a second great prophet, as I want that. I want to enhance my religion as soon as possible. Okay, so I'm over the river. Now I need to head down and deal with this encampment. Stop it from spawning barbarians. So off we go. So it can be pretty boring just clicking through turns at this stage in the game. But that's nothing compared to later in the game when the turns take a lot longer. So yeah, there is an encampment there. There's some horses there too. So maybe this would be a spot for a city actually. It might be. There's a river there, and it's on the desert edge. Anyway, I'll go after that barbarian regardless. Okay, so apparently I've got the most wonders at one. Okay, next turn I'll have that barbarian dealt with. Bronze working. Iron has been discovered somewhere. Oh, at Adrianople. Okay. And there's iron over there. Right, okay. What to research now? Iron working. No, I should actually catch up those other texts there. Clear the encampment, and I'm going to want to take that archer out. Okay, so social policy. If I take this one, that speeds up my worker. If I take this one, I improve my production. And that leads me to the free settler. I'm going to take this one because it speeds up production and leads to the free settler policy. So that should get my production up to a better level in my cities here. Right. So I'm going to take out that bloody archer there. So I'm getting the social policies a lot faster because I took the honor opener, with six or seven or eight culture per kill. When I'm only getting seven culture per turn, I didn't get the pyramids. Well, that's annoying. I should have gone for the Great Library. Okay, is there a... Barbarian nearby to go after? Not really. I'm gonna send a warrior over there just to open this tile up. So I got a bunch of gold from that project anyway. Great Lighthouse, maybe. I'm just going to take a shot at the Great Library, just in case. I know I'm not going to get it, but I'm going to take a shot at it anyway. But I was not far off the pyramids. That's the annoying bit. But that's the way it goes. Again, I'm not getting into somebody else's war. So we'll tick along here. Right. Okay, next move there is going to. Where the blazes did that come from? Must have been wandering around, or there's a. Oh, there's another encampment there I'm gonna want to go after. Okay, yeah, there was nothing in there. That's good to know. So I'm gonna have to go after this. So I'll send my warrior down there, and I'll attack this bugger. Okay, well, that's archery. Wheel. That's what I want. So I can build city connections. Okay, so that's there. So go after that, see if clear that encampment. Yeah, see, I wouldn't have made the Great Library either. I would have been like one turn short on the construction, so that's not that big of a loss. Okay. And I'll make a farm there too. Now, what to build here? Stoneworks would be a good idea. I'm gonna actually take a shot at the Great Lighthouse. Oh, what have I got here? Blitz, which is double attack. That's on a hill. I'll go for drill one so I get better attack here. And, okay, that gets rid of that. Next turn, I'll, okay, the wonders are coming fast and furious now. Okay, that's cleared. Carthage. I'm going to be getting my second great profit real soon now. 890 faith there. So I'll attack there. Yeah, I'll accept the embassy there. Okay, came from a long way off. Okay. So barbarian gonna, no, he's gonna run. Oh, there's a encampment up there. Okay. And there's another one over here. Man. Okay, that gets rid of that brute. That's good. Ah, there's my great prophet. So I will enhance my religion. Oh, that's an archer. Okay, second follower belief. Religious art. Okay. Each world wonder provides two faith. That might be worth going for, actually. Holy warriors. Nope. Peace gardens, hermitage. Right. This one could be good, but I'm gonna go with divine inspiration and religion spreads 25% faster. Yeah, I'll go with religious texts. So we'll enhance the religion. So that's even more faith. Right. Then I'll start building my faith buildings once the faith accumulates enough. And that'll be good for my culture, happiness, and faith generation. Right, next turn. Okay, that did for that archer there. Now I need to go over to that other one over here, get rid of it. Okay, actually, I've got enough gold that I can get a settler out. So I'm going to do that. Since neither one of my cities is really particularly good at generating production and so on right now. What I'm going to do is I'm going to aim for a city over here. So 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. This is actually a perfect spot here. I'm right beside the mountain there, but I actually, this might be better. I'm still within 2 of the mountain, and I still get all of the resources that would have been there otherwise. And I reached that second horses over there, so I'll send my settler around there. Of course, the city connection back to the capital is going to be annoying. It's going to have to come through here. I can fire on an enemy there. Okay, mathematics. That gives me hanging gardens. That requires tradition, construction. That gives me the lumber mill, trapping, iron working. I'm gonna go for trapping. Okay, there we go there. Now, I need to get my gold production up before I run out of gold, because I don't want my science impacted. I'm already behind on enough stuff. I don't want to get behind on science as well. Where's the encampment? Oh. Well, that's way away from anything I care about at the moment, so that's not too big of a deal. Where's this one? Okay, again, that's not a big deal. That guy's gone. And I'll be able to go after that guy right away here. Right. And I can build my city this next turn here, and maybe I'll be lucky enough to get Petra. Petra would be immensely useful there, but I'll build that. Right. Yeah, shrine. Okay, so this city's actually got reasonably decent production. So that's good. Oh, met Ethiopia. Okay, that's dealt with the hand axe there. Good. Right. Does the warrior have embarkation? If it doesn't, I should get it back to. Yeah, he does. Okay. So I don't see anything over there. I should train a scout here, but anyway. I'm gonna actually send the warrior up there just to see if there's anything worth looking at up there. Ormus wants a trade route. Of course, doing the warrior through the water there without a boat is slightly risky. Where? Oh, yeah, I should have left him at home. Anyway, I'll let him explore up there, and then I'll bring him back down to the barbarian there. Wow, barbarians are spawning fast and furious here. Where are these buggers coming from? Over there, I'll bet. Really need to get another warrior or a swordsman or something out. Oh. Yeah, that's what I figured. There wasn't going to be much up there. Okay. Trapping. Okay. Horseback riding. Mathematics, construction, philosophy allows building the oracle. I'm going to go for that. The Oracle gives a free social policy, which is really nice to have. Okay, let's see where Ethiopia is. Yeah. So far, the civilizations are spread out fairly evenly, which doesn't always happen. Okay, I've got my settler there. Right. I need a warrior. And where was I thinking to put a city here? I was thinking down here, wasn't I? Which would be good. That would give. Okay. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1. This would be just about perfect here, actually. So that would give access to the horses down here, the dyes, the iron, and the horses up here. And the production range of the city wouldn't run off the coast. So, yeah, that's what I'm going to do. And this encampment should be far enough away it doesn't bother the settler on the way down. Right, okay, so that is that. What I should do is start working on the city connection here. Although that's going to make my gold go more negative. I really do need to improve this stuff over here, though. So I'm going to go and get the iron improved there with a mine. So I really need to have the iron. Okay, I've got my shrine there. Build my monument. Good. That barbarian's dealt with. And I'll have to deal with this one. Okay, so I'll plot my city down there, Antioch. Okay, what have I got here? I can go with drill 2 for rough terrain or blitz. I'm going to go with blitz. Because that also means that the unit can move after attacking. Go for a shrine in Antioch. Gonna have to build some more workers here too. Now, as a result of this, I've now got my gold at 0, which is good. So I'll build the mine there. Right, I need to kill that bugger. Where'd that one come from? Was he just rattling around loose over there? Right. So I'm going for the city sprawl type tactic here. I do need to get some resources improved, luxuries, so that I get the happiness back up to something sensible. Right. Wonder if these guys are spawning because of unhappiness in the Empire, actually. Maybe that's the case. Well, whatever the reason, I do have enough luxury resources that once I manage to improve them, I will actually get out of that happiness hole. Right. Ooh, that's gonna be a problem. Yeah, that's got to be due to unhappiness in the empire. How long is that going to take? 11. So, next thing up is going to be a workboat. So that I can improve the whales here. And it's obviously going to be in Constantinople where I end up doing that. Okay, I can buy something with faith. So, purchase. This gives me 2 happiness, so that will improve things. And that should be enough to get things over even. Ah, there we go. Great lighthouse. No wonders to build there, but I definitely need a workboat. Okay. Ethiopia has managed to enhance their religion. On the upside, I'm getting a fair bit of culture out of killing barbarians here, so it's not that bad having them pop up like that. Okay, let me clear that. Okay, good. That barbarian encampment is sorted out. Okay, so I should send the warrior over where my worker is. I don't really want to lose the worker. That would be really, really inconvenient at this stage of the game. So I'll just make sure I don't. Okay, I've made a warrior there. What are my options here? Oh, yes, I need another worker. Right. Well, I'll leave the warrior there for now. Oh, okay, it's over there. Ah, there's one. Should just deal with that right away. Okay, so that's iron. And I need to get another luxury up. Okay, so we'll go for a monument there. I'm up to 23 faith per turn. That's pretty good. Wow. Yeah, they've got to be spawning like that because of unhappiness in the empire. Ooh, religion spread. Oh, religion spread again. Okay, I've got a workboat there, so now I'm gonna build the stoneworks, because I have those two stone quarries, and the workboat, bring it out here, and there we go. Empire is now happy. Okay, I'll get this, clear that. Good. And I'll get this operating to connect the dies. I think... Okay, I'll get this guy heading over here. Okay, so I'm up over an hour for this part, so I'm going to call that the end of the part here at turn 299, so that's actually turn 300, since the game actually starts on turn 0. So that's the end of part 2. If you've watched this long, thanks for watching. I'll see you all back for part 3.